SUVW, that seems to be the mantra for the VW group in India, and it seems to be working. In just a couple of months, the Tiguan, which is the Tiguan's smaller brother, has now done over 6,000 units or so. That's a whole bunch of cars for the VW group, and that's a great thing because that SUV craze seems to be working for VW as well, and that's why we now have the Tiguan facelift, which is back. Now, the Tiguan originally was a more squared off product in terms of the way it looked. This is a more rounded off car, not just in terms of design, but in terms of an overall car as well. But we'll get to all those bits later. First and foremost, a couple of things you need to know. This is now 31.99 lakh rupees ex showroom. Not a bad price for one of these, considering the fact that it does give you a lot of power, a lot of features, etc. etc. We'll get to again those in a bit. But again, as I mentioned, a more rounded product. Not just in terms of the way it overall is, but also in terms of design. Let me explain. The original Tiguan, which we had, which was of course succeeded by the Tiguan Allspace, which is the 7-seater version of the Tiguan, which has now been discontinued in favor of this one, used to be a more boxish car. It had a whole bunch of angles and a whole bunch of cuts and stuff, which made it look nice and butch, but it was squared off. This is more rounded off as design elements. So it's got a more rounded off headlamp, more rounded off grille, etc., etc. It looks in sync with the international design language that VW has. I particularly like these new LED daytime running light elements that VW, of course, has been doing on a bunch of their cars. And of course, you get now these bigger 18-inch wheels as well. So overall, the car does look a lot more softer, a lot more approachable. And I like this color, this tomato red. I think it looks rather cool. There are more colors here, of course. There's a silver, which is very typically VW in terms of the way it looks. And then there's that blue behind my camera guy here, which again looks nice. We'll put a shot of that as a picture or a video clip here. But you know what? What's missing? The R-Line kit on the Tiguan, which has been the pictures used for all the communications. That's of course not coming to India, mainly because of the way it costs. This, again, if you compare it to its rivals, costs about the same. If you compare it to, say, the larger scheme of things, it is a bit pricey, but it does get a whole bunch of stuff. Now, coming to the rear, and this gives me a chance to talk about something else before I get to design language, which of course is sort of similar as what it used to be, with the big exception of the Tiguan badge now being moved to the center as compared to it being somewhere here in the past, and the nice new VW flush logo, which we will also see on the inside in a bit. But of course, you have the nicer looking LED sort of tail lamps as well, another change. But the one thing that you need to know is this little badge here, 4Motion. That means this is all-wheel drive. That's not the only thing that this car gets in terms of mechanical updates. It's also now only petrol. So all those massive VW diesel fans do have something to be a little bit sad about. But you know, VW Group in India just does not have a diesel anymore, sadly. And it's just the 2-litre petrol engine with 190 horsepower. Now, I can tell you for a fact that that engine is really strong, moves really well, especially in the Allspace, and this is a smaller car. So I'd expect this to be even quicker and nicer. You know what? This is a really, really good car to drive, and we're going to get you a drive review very, very soon. But I can already tell you that this is a nice, nice car to drive, especially paired up with this all-wheel drive and that beautiful, beautiful 2-litre TSI engine up front. Okay then, enough of the exterior updates and the mechanical bits. Let's go on the inside and see what's new. We'll wait for the beep to go away. And it's gone away. Right, now if you've been in the interior of a Tiguan in the past, the normal 5-seat Tiguan, it was a lot more, well, analog. This one is completely digital everywhere. So you've got the nice new digital instrument cluster, which is really, really crisp and nice looking in terms of the way everything is laid out. And it's got this sort of matte finish on it, which makes it very, very clear to read in bright sunlight as well. So that's a positive. Of course, you've got that massive panoramic sunroof up top, and you've got a new digital instrument cluster too. Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, all the connected apps that you ever need, everything is really in there. And of course, you are looking now at this new Volkswagen logo on the steering wheel as well. It's nice and sort of flush with the steering wheel. Feels nice to touch, although that's very weird. Nonetheless, that's not a fetish I have, okay? I'm just going to put it out there. This is now a much nicer cabin as compared to what it was before. And of course, all the quality of everything is very plush. The seats are nice and comfortable and they're soft. Although the one big thing that they're missing, which I don't understand why, is of course cool seats. You do have heated seats, which you really don't need in India, do you now, with the temperatures we've got? But the cool seats seem to have been given a miss. sad because at this price point, cool seats need to be in that list of all the features you have. That said, again, everything very German, very cleanly designed, very crisp and black interiors, nice little carbon fiber sort of finish on the dashboard as well. Overall, a very good place for you and your family to be. Not a seven-seater, but I think this smaller Tiguan makes a lot more sense for the Indian market.